word in your Ayurveda is expressed, all technical terms are coined with the support of Sanskrit grammar. Each word has got its own input. That's why you are learning Paryaya. You know that Paryaya means synonyms. Because each synonym has got its own important, and the place they are used also is very, very important. Sometimes the dosha will be called as dhatu, you can say. Sometimes the dosha can be called as mala, you can find out. So this context, from that you can understand that why dosha is called mala over there. It is because of the technical term that which is coined with that language, that is the soul of Ayurveda. So learning Ayurveda is not simply learning the santi of the Laku Siddhanta Kaumudi. It is learning into the depth of that language, Sanskrit, through which you can really master each term in your Ayurvedic Samhitas. This is what is you have to keep in your mind, and you know that Acharya Panini is the first scholar to design a scientific grammar for the languages in the whole world. If you take the whole world, which is the very first grammar text on language, if anybody asks you, immediately you say that it is Panini, the book's name is Ashtadhyayi. Ashtadhyayi is a very big book, and nowadays also there are Gurukulas in your north, east, center and southern part of India. Gurukulas are there. There they learn the Panini Sutras from 5 years to 14 years, 15 years like that. Recently I have gone to MP, one of the Gurukula. There a child of 11 years, he says all the sutras of Panini very beautifully with sutra, sutrartha and udharana, without even a single sight on the textbook. There is no textbook at all. He was sitting and he was just simply telling them. I was wondering how powerful the brain of Indians are. I will say how powerful the brains of Indians are. You know that Panini has got such a computing brain. So he arranged a grammar in the same methodology of computer software. So that is why Sanskrit is known as computer language. Actually, that idea is being given by Panini, who was a great scholar of Sanskrit with a large storage space in his brain. And you see the idea that which he has arranged the vowels and consonants in such a way that it is called Maheshwara Sutra. Therefrom, the computing starts. Actually, we will learn A, A, E, E, U, U, R, R, L, A, O, I, Au, Am, Aha. Like this, we will learn the swaras. You see how beautifully Panini has done. I, U, N, R, L, A, O, N, I, Ouch. Finish. I, U, N, R, L, A, O, N, I, Ouch. Only four sutras. A, E, U, R, R, A, O, I, Au. Only with four sutras, he said that vowels in such a beautiful way that all the rules in his textbook can be made very less space and maximum idea in it. This is what is you will learn in the Sapnya Pragrana in your first year. Halantyam, Tasya Lopaha, Adirantyena Saheta. Like this, all sutras you learn in the Sapnya Pragrana, if you would have seen the Laku Siddhanta Kaumudi, all that Sapnya Pragrana is meant for teaching you how to understand a grammar textbook. After that, the rules. That's the purpose of teaching Sapnya Pragrana. So, Ayyunurul Keyong Ayyav Chayavarat Alana Nyamangana Nama Jabhanya Ghadadash Javagadadash Kapa Jatata Jatata Vakavaya Shatata Hale. This is the Maheshwara Sutra. If you go through, there are 14 sutras. A, E, U, N, R, L, E, O, N, I, O, C. You see, A, E, U, N. N is something called Itta Sapnya. You don't have to consider for the grammatical rule. That is the sutra Halantyam in your Laku Siddhanta Kaumudi, the very first sutra of Sapnya Pragrana. Hal, Andye, whatever it may be you are seeing, Andhya means end of a sutra. It is a hal. Hal means it is the coin word for consonants. Vyanjana Akshara. Hal is the computing language for the whole consonants. Only two space, but your brain will call k k g gh ng ch ch j jh ny ta th d d na tha th d dh na pa pha bha bha ma ya ra la va sa sha sa ha kshatra jna. All these consonants will come in your mind with only two space, that is hal. Here starts the software methodology of Panini. So here hal is starting from hayavarat. Hayavarat lana nyamangana nama jabanya ghadadash japagadadash kapachatada chatatava kabaya sarsasare hal. You can see the ha hayavarat, ha begins with ha, and at the end hal ends with l. So joining these two, he created a small two-spaced word, ha and l, to explain all the consonants. So here again, once again I told you, the computing of Panini. And you see how he has arranged? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The consonant Vargaksharas are arranged in such a way that Nyamanganam, this is the fifth columns. Jabhanya Ghatadash, it is the fourth column. Javagadadash, third column. Kapa chatatha, second column. Chatatava kapaye, first column. And he arranged the rules also in such a beautiful manner for explaining the sutras. That is why you learn sutra. Sutra definition is alpaksharam asandiktam saravat vishvatomukam. Like this. Less space, maximum information. That is why your Ashtanga Hridaya, the first chapter is called Sutrasthana. Sutrasthana is the consolidated form of the whole Samhitas, whether it is Ashtanga Hridaya or Charaka Samhita or whatever be the textbook. That's why it is called Sutrasthana. So the Sutra style is first formed by Panini. So this is the way he has arranged. And you know that the scholars of India, especially ancient India, they never take any credit of their knowledge for themselves. They will attribute everything in the divine power. That is why he called that sutra as Maheshwara Sutra. That is, you can see, that is why Sanskritam is called the Sanskriti, culture. It's the beauty of, again, once again, the language. So he called them as Maheshwara Sutra. From the dakka of Maheshwara, this sound comes. That's why that tune he kept. Ayunar lakke yongayau chayavaradalana nyamangana nama jabhanya gadadash jabagadadash kapachadadachadadava kabaya shadasari hal. That idea he has kept. And it is very easy to be remembered. Idea of arranging the vowels in this, vowels and consonants in this way, is for remembering very fast. Same way Sutrasthana is also for memorizing. It is very fast. We do not, that time there were no computers, no notebooks, no pens, nothing. Everything has to be heard and stored and recalled. Okay. So this is what is the way of construction of Laghu Siddhanta Kaumudeswarya Panini Sutras. And there was a scholar, he has said Mattoji Dikshita, Vaiyagarana Siddhanta Kaumudi. He found that students are struggling year by year. The quality of the brain started coming down. So what he has done, he consolidated again small textbook. It is called Vaiyagarana Siddhanta Kaumudi. That is written by Bhattoji Dikshita. Even we are not learning that one. After that, Varadarada Acharya is the author of the Laghu Siddhanta Kaumudi, that which we are learning. It is the smallest textbook designed for learning Sanskrit grammar in a simplest way for the pupil, for the student. This is the idea of writing Laghu Siddhanta Kaumudi. This much you understand now. Now, Sanskrit, I told you, it's not a language. It's a science itself. And if you enter into that, you know, should know that how the Sanskrit sentences are. Every language, there will be a subject and predicate in the sentence. The predicate is consists of object and verb. And when you consider Sanskrit, you can place the subject in one place, verb in another place, object in another place. The meaning won't change. Finally, you will write the prose order and you will get the meaning. Any other language, if you place, change comes. If you put the subject in different place, the meaning also will be changing. But Sanskrit, there is no such problem at all. Wherever you put the word, finally, you will get the perfect meaning of the sentence. It is because the suffixes for denoting the meanings along with the noun word are attached to the nouns. That means, suppose you are all Hindi speaking. Ram ke liye pustak de raha hun. Ram ke liye. So that ke liye is separate in a Hindi. But if you say Sanskrit, it will become Ramaya. You cannot remove that aya suffix from Rama. It is attached to Rama. Ramaya. So this is the advantage of Sanskrit language. The suffixes are added along with the root word to give a perfect meaning for that word, along with the prepositions called either in Hindi or in English. Keliye, you can translate in English as for. That for is there in Ramaya. So like this, perfect, clear word formation is there in Sanskrit. And no other language except Indian languages does not have the sandhi. Sandhi means two words joining together. Two words joining together. This is only there in our Indian languages. So two words can be joined to one word. So it is very much needed to understand the word in by splitting them into parts. Then you will get the word. Then you will go for the meaning. Then you will go for the complete meaning of the sentence. So splitting and understanding is very, very important in Sanskrit because Santi is there. One more thing. Another important thing is samasa or compound words. The compound words are there in Sanskrit language. Without that, without knowing compounding, you cannot understand the word in the context because the samasa or vigrahavakya has got its own characteristics. You would have studied in your first year. Kevala samasa, abhibhava samasa, tatpurusha samasa, bahuvrihi samasa, and duntva samasa. Five types of samasa you would have learned in your first year. Here, kevala samasa may not have much examples, but abhibhava samasa, there are a lot of examples in your Ashtanga Hridayam or Saragamita or any Ayurvedic textbook. Tatpurusha, plenty you can see because Tatpurusha has got Dhigu Samasa, Visheshana Visheshya, Upamana Upameya. There are varieties of Samasa in Tatpurusha Samasa. Same way, Bahuvrihi Samasa is also Anya Padartha Pradhano, Bahuvrihi. Lot of words are there. Dhuntva Samasa is a integrated part of Ayurveda. Without Dhuntva Samasa, slogas cannot be formed. So, what is difference between Santi and Samasa? After that, I will enter into the Santi. Santi is joining of two words without any deletion of the suffixes. Without any deletion of the suffixes. Suffix, the word in Sanskrit is pratyaya. Pratyayam is suffix. So without deleting, if two words joining, it is Santi. If the suffixes are removed and the words are joining, then it is called samasa or compounding. Deleting the suffixes, if the words are joining together, then it is called samasa or compound word. Without deleting the suffixes, when the words are joining, then it is called Santhi. Clear for you? I hope it is clear. So learning Santhi is a must to understand first level of learning. Second level of learning is learning Vigrahavakya or compound word is a must to understand the second level of understanding. Then to understand the word meaning, you should know Nirukti. You would have heard about the Nirukti. Vati iti vataha va gati gantaneyoho karmani ikta prateye vataha iti rupam. This is called Nirukti and Nishpatti. Nirukti means vati iti vataha is the Nirukti. It is called Nirukti. Yaska is the acharya who has written the Nirukti. Niruktam is the textbook. So derivation of a word or definition of a word is called Nirukti. From that you have to understand the meaning of the word. And Vigrahavakya is the expansion of compound word. So where there is samasa, you will be asked to write Vigrahavakya. Where there is single word, then we have to go for the Nirukti. So this is the process. After Nirukti, you will go for Nishpatti. Nishpatti means from which root it is formed, what is the meaning of that root, and which suffix is added to get that word. And you see, being the Ayurvedic scholars, you should know in which adhikarana, which context the word is used. Then you should think a lot to get the right meaning of the word. This much process is there to understand the meaning of a single word for an Ayurvedic scholar. Okay, so I told you Satnya Prakarana is mainly written for us to understand how to understand the grammar and how to understand the alphabets and how to understand the culture of the language. This is the idea in Satnya Prakarana. Then you start with Achsandhi Prakarana. So Maheshwara Sutra is arranged for less space, maximum information. And this is purely the powerful brain of Panini. But again, I'm telling you, quality of Indian scholars, ancient scholars, they never had said, today Charu introduced me, he published 10 papers, he was working over there, all my whereabouts are told. You see Panini Vyakarana, Panini did not tell anything. See the, what we'll say, selfless service to, selfless expression of the knowledge. Now, we say one page of the explanation of the speaker. We concentrate on what we, than what we are going to tell. So this is what is, we have to understand that our culture is changing towards the self-centered. We are not supposed to, because there the lack of quality comes. Anyhow, so this is the way of writing. So Maheshwara Sutra is really the creation of Panini, but it is being attributed to Lord Parameshwara. Because you know that Lord Parameshwara is the God who is there with the people who are in the working or in the level of service sections. Lord Vishnu is a protector in the one more higher stage. Lord Brahma, he creates only. See the, again, Lord Brahma creates, Lord Vishnu just protects whenever you have difficulty, and whatever be the life you are leading, they're all Maheshwara, because you know that your body is created with Panjamahabhuta. Who is the God of Panjamahabhuta? Blindly you say that it's Lord Shiva. See, that is the beauty of the creation or the faith in the God in Indian culture. So Lord Maheshwara is the person who is going to give you all the things that which you are using, maintaining in your life to exist. Only your existence being assured by Lord Vishnu, and your creation is done by Brahma. This is the concept of that. So these words are given for Maheshwara Sutra. You know that. Vagartha vivasampruttau vagartha prativattaye jagatap pitarau vante parvati parameshwaro. जगत पितरौ हु इज द पितरौ माता च पिता च पितरौ एकशेष समास फादर एंड मदर पेरेंट इंग्लिश टर्मिनोलॉजी दैट इज एक्चुअली इन संस्कृत पितरौ व्हेन इन इंग्लिश यू से पेरेंट इट इंक्लूड्स फादर एंड मदर इन संस्कृत द सेम वर्ड इज पितरौ इट इंक्लूड्स फादर एंड मदर सो लॉर्ड शिवा एंड पार्वती आर कंसिडर्ड एज द फादर एंड मदर ऑफ द यूनिवर्स सो दैट इज वाई माहेश्वर सूत्र He is attributed for Lord Shiva, and from his dakka it comes. So I hope you understood that part, and Maheshwara Sutra will be there in everybody's mind, no doubt, because you would have byhearted it in a well good manner. Now we are entering into the Sapnya Prakarana Charu. I will just very fast reading. I will make in Sapnya Prakarana. Move your page to Sapnya Prakarana. Not this, little more. Halantyam. It start from Halantyam. Halantya. Yeah. See, this is the starting of the Sapnya Prakarana. Very first sutra is Halantyam. It is the sutra which decides it sapnya. It is the sapnya for the last consonant of an avyaya, of a root, of a Maheshwara sutra, or whatever it may be. So that small part is considered as the terminology it. He used the term. It for that one. Upadesha andyam halitsya. If there is any upadesha, basic form. Upadesha means basic form. In that one, at the end, andye, hal, any consonant is there. That consonant can be called as it. It sapnyam sya. Upadesha adhyocharanam. Whatever you are pronouncing, that is called adhyocharanam. This is all detail. You don't want this much. Only it sapnya is given for that it sapnya cannot be considered or should not be considered for any of the grammatical process. It will be subjected to lopa. Lopa means deletion. It does not have to be considered. But you can consider the first letter and up to that. For that one he made the adhirantyena saheta. It is pratyahara sapnya vidhayakam sutram. Adhirantyena saheta is a pratyahara sapnya vidhayakam. That means ach, ik, yanu. Like this, so many small terms you would have. Iko yanachi, akasavarne dirgaha, ak is a pratyahara. Ak is a pratyahara, is a terminology. Pratyahara means a terminology. Ak is to get the information that a, e, u, r, lr. Ayuna, rluk. In that one, ayuna, n is not subjected for the grammar, so it is removed. Rluk. The k is kept over there. From a to k, two sutras, a, e, u, r, lr, five letters. So ak means five alphabets included in that one. So he defined the terminology as pratyahara. And he gave the meaning, andhyena ita sahita adihi madhyaganam sosyaja sapnyasya. So ik, e is a word, complete alphabet. K is an itta, and that terminology is for understanding the alphabets in between A and K. That means A, E, U. N is a itta, it is subjected for deletion. R, lr, so five letters. There are five alphabets in Ak. Like this, he created a terminology. That terminology is called pratyahara. The sutra for that one is Adhirantyena Saheta. Come on, up. Sorry, little more. All. Still. Go to the next page. 16. Next page. Yes. Now, so he taught you what is alphabet, how the grammar textbook is explaining the alphabets in the small terminology is called pratyahara. Now he is telling that whether he has to take only the hraswakshara, a alone? No. A has got another two division which are called dirgha and pluta. Dirgha and pluta. Dirgham means you will take two matra for pronunciation. See, a is a letter. A. Actually, we all pronounce a. Actually, you should not pronounce A. Your mouth should be closed. A. is the pronunciation. Yes. Now, if you want the long ah, 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 is the long. Now, ah, it is plural. Ah, ah, ah. The difference you see. Ah, ah, ah. So, a is hraswa, a is dirgha, a is pluta. Pluta generally we'll use for calling. If Krishna is far away, we'll call Krishna, we'll call. That is pluta. Radhe, we will call. Sita, we will call. They're all that a, it is called pluta. Plutas will be mainly for calling a person. Okay, but Dirga is there with Akara and the Strilinga for formation. Dirga is compulsory. So Hraswa and Dirga are always there for grammatical Santi influence. How they are made? Ukalo ach Hraswa Dirga Pluta Satnyasya. So what he has made? Uscha, uscha, uscha. He gave an example. U, u, u. And like this, if you pronounce each alphabet, then it can be called as hraswa dirgha. So, u, 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 a, 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 e, 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 like this, r, 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 l, 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 but l is very less. Same way you can make. But a does not have hraswa, o does not have hraswa, I does not have hraswa, they are all dirgha only. There's no hraswa akshara for a, o, I, and au. Clear? So this is three types of. So one matra, two matra, three matra. Matra, you would have studied the measurement in your Ayurveda. Matra is always considered as the shortest measurement. Matra should be considered as the shortest measurement. Okay? The shortest measurement is matra. Now, pronunciation. Again, how to pronounce? See, we all pronounce as we wish, and the influence of mother tongue also. This is the way we pronounce each alphabet in Sanskrit. But there is, they are telling that Uchair Udataha, Nichair Anudataha, Samahara Swaritaha. Three type of pronunciation each alphabet. You can pronounce just Udatta. Udatta means if there is a place of articulation, if the place of articulation upper part comes, then it is Udatta. If middle lower part comes, Anudatta. If both together comes, Swarita. Three types of pronunciation. This you can see in, especially in Vedas. Sahasra Shirsha Purushaha 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 Roshaha Ru. Who will go up? Purushaha. Like this, accents are there. If the accent change, the meaning will change. You just imagine, like this, Kumbhakarna has got Sendra Shatru, like this. There are accents. Saraswati sat in the tongue and changed the word, the meaning changes. So accent change, meaning change. In Vedas especially, in mantras especially. So each mantra or each Veda when you pronounce, the accents has to be taken care, very much care. You will call phonology in your English, American accent, German accent, like this, different accents, you know that. Sanskrit also has got perfect accent system. They are called Udatta, Anudatta, Swarita. This we generally do not use in our classical reading. If you use in classical reading, it will give you the perfect Sandhi words. Raga, raga, tirokan, satata, anushaktan, Anushaktan, Satata, Anushaktan. That A upper comes, Anushaktan, you will get. Autsukya Moharatitan, Autsukya Moharati. That Moha, after that A, if you give Udata, you will get Arati. Otherwise, you will get Autsukya Moharatitan. You will get Ratitan. It is actually Arati. Autsukya Moharatitan, Aratitan. Moharatitan jagana. Understood. So we can use the Udata, Anudata, Swarita in our regular reading also, understanding the Sandhi and the beginning of the words. So that will give very perfect understanding of the words in a shloka. Okay, especially the Santi Purva Rupa Santi, right? Purva Rupa Santi, Ye and Avagraha will come. In all that places, Te Abhi, Te Abhi, Te Abhi, Te Abhi, Te Abhi, Te Abhi, Abhi, you give it in the upper part. One letter space will not come, but because of the Udata, you will get that Te plus Abhi, Te Abhi, Ramovi, Ramaha plus Abhi, Ramovi, Visarga Santi. In all places, you can use the Udata in a perfect manner for understanding the words in a shloka or in the santis. Anyhow, there are three types of accent: Udata, Anudata, Swarga. Udata is the place of articulation, upper part, Anudata, lower part, Swarga mixed together. Okay? I hope you understood these three types of the pronunciation. That's why I told you characteristics of the language. Next, page 17, 18. Yeah, next you see there is letter Anunasika, Anunasika, not that table, that sutra you put down. Yes. Mukanasika Vajano Anunasika. You see, actually those who speak Hindi, they will use maximum nasal sounds, right? The nasal sound will be more in the Hindi language characteristic generally. Ram ke samne. If a Malayali speaks Ram, he will say that Ram ke samne, Ra, he will use. Throat he will use more. But Hindi speaking area, Ram ke samne, that nasal part will be more. If you go to Malayali, he will speak in such a way that Kanda he will use more. And if you come to the northern part, they will use nasal part more. But actually there is a rule. You must use kanta as well as you must use nasal. Different pronunciations are there. That's why Anunasika and Ananunasika. Nasika means nose. Yeah. Mukha means mouth. If you pronounce Mukha and Nasika, it is called Anunasika. Mukha and Nasika together, it is called Anunasika. If there is no Nasika, then it is Ananunasika. Only Mukha, Ananunasika. So, if from the kanta, with the nose. Have you seen? It is from the kanta. No nose at all. But if you pronounce, the part of nasal comes. Even that can change the meaning in Vedas. You must understand that even that type of pronunciation can change the accent and the meanings in Vedic language. Clear? This is very, very important for understanding the Anunasika and Nasika. Now you see, alphabet, A is an alphabet. It has got Hraswa, Dirga, Pluta. And it has got the pronunciation Udata, Anudata, Swarita. And it has got Anunasika, Anununasika. So total 18 type of pronunciation for one alphabet A. You imagine how he would have worked in that one. That is, for us, A is A only. For classical Sanskrit, A is A only. But Panini has worked under that a long way. And he found that a letter R can be pronounced in 18 types. I hope you understood. Ashtadasha Veda. 18 varieties are there. So this is also another wonder that which the Panini has done with our language. That means he has gone through the Vedic language. He has gone through the classical language. He has traveled all over India. He found the pupil's pronunciation and the meanings and the changes. Everything connected, he arranged this Udata, Anudata, Swarita, Hraswa, Dirga, Pluta, and Anunasika and Ananunasika. So this is the way of pronunciation of the word. I hope you are following me, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, fine, good. And next part, come on, Charu, next. Because 2 hours, I have to complete Atsandhi. Then at least one shloka I want to make them learn. Okay. Next one, Tulyasya Prayatnam Savaranam. See, if ताल्वादिस्थानम् आभ्यन्तर प्रयत्नम् च एतद्वयम् यस्य येन तुल्यम् तन्मितः सवर्ण सत्यम् स्यात्. देयर इज ए कॉल्ड सवर्ण. सवर्ण मीन्स ए वर्ण एन अल्फाबेट विल बी सिमिलर टू नेक्स्ट वन कंसिडरिंग देयर प्लेसेस ऑफ आर्टिकुलेशन. Considering the prayatna that which we are giving. Now you see, ka is a letter. Ka is a letter. Second one is ka. See, ka is very relaxed one. Alpa prana. Ka, alpa prana. See the second one, ka. You stopped that air and relieved all of a sudden. So, ka. See the third letter, ga, 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 ga. See the fourth letter, G, G, Mahaprana. And next one is Na, Na, with the Na, Nais, Na. Have you noticed? That is called Yakna. So, no. Alpaprana, Mahaprana, as well as place of articulation. Actually, Ka is the letter, everything is formed from Kantha. Actually, Ka, the formation place is Kantha. Ka, Ka. Ga, ga, na. You see, your articulation space will be completely open. No block, nothing. Very open. Ka, ka, ka. You can sit like this and say, ka, ka, ga, ga, na. Correct? You are modulating only the air. Alpa prana, maha prana. Alpa prana, maha prana, nasal. That's all. But the sound is produced from kantha. Because your vocal system full open, same way it will stay back. If you draw the picture, you can see it will not change. Hope you understood, right? This is the pronunciation. So considering them, Bahya and Abhyantara Prayatna, if two words are having the same, then they can be called as Savarna. Savarna means Sa is always Samam. Sa letter will be always Samam. So, sa varna. So, that varna will be sa varna of this varna. So, that satnya is called sa varna satnya. R, lir, r, lir, r, lir. Between them, there is sa varnatum. R, lir, r, lir. You see, you pronounce, you can see. R, lir. Noticed? You can see both from the guttural, upper part, that part of your mouth. Right? So that is why it is Savarna Sapnya. Like this, Ril Ravarna Yormitaha Savarnyam Vachyam. Like this, Savarna Sapnya. Yeah, I hope this is also, I told you what is Savarna. Why he is telling all this? Because while pronouncing, while you are adding, see, Maha plus Rishi, Maharishi. Maha plus Rishi, Maharishi. Maha plus Rishi, Maharishi. Maharishi. But I told you, in your side, you will pronounce it as Maharishi. Rishi you will pronounce. Ri. Because you will not pronounce R. R. Very difficult for the powerful climatical condition. Because in the area will be either hot or cold. So your mouth will not be properly setting for pronouncing R sound. So you will pronounce Ri. With the support of E, you will pronounce the sound R. Okay? That is because of the influence of the climate as well as the local language. Actually, r is the sound. You see, the tongue will be just vibrating on the guttural. Yeah. Okay, that is the pronunciation. So now coming to the proper places of articulation. Akuha visarjaniyanam kantaha. Ichuyashana, you can see, beautifully you can see, when you, morning time, if you sit and pronounce, you can pronounce. Akuha visarjaniyana. A, kavarga, ha, and visarga will be from kantha. The sound will be produced from kantha. A, ka, 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 na. Ka, 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 na. Ka, 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 na. You can see, ka, 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 na. Here vibration will be there. Ka, 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 na. You can see. Yeah, visarga. Ha, ha, ha. You can see it will be from the kanda. Okay. Now, ichu yashana talu. You see, your tongue will be just behind the teeth. It will be touching. E. Cha, 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 nya. Yeah, yeah. You see, your tongue will be just touching in the palatal. That means just behind the teeth. That is the pronunciation. That is talu, palatal. You sit and pronounce it. Yeah, cha 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 nya. Your tongue, you see, cha 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 nya. It will be just behind. Yeah, same way. So ichu yashanam talu. Ruddu rashana murdha. Murdha means guttural, the upper part. Rr, ta ta da da na. See the tongue? Ta ta da da na. It will be hitting on the upper part like this. Ta ta da da na. You can see.
Ta ta da da na.
Yeah. R, 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 shabdam. Rr, shabdam. All will be from there. That is why it is murdha. It is guttural. That guttural part.
Ruddu rashana.
Yeah. La, la. You see, your tongue will be in the upper upper teeth. Your tongue will be pressing it. La, la, ta, ta. It will be hitting in the teeth. That's why that sound is from danta. Lirutu lasanam danta. You can see, small difference. E, cha, the tongue will not touch the teeth. But if you wanted to pronounce ta, the tongue will touch the danta. That is the difference between talu and danta. You can pronounce. Cha you pronounce, tongue will not touch the teeth. Cha. Correct? You pronounce ta, the tongue will touch the teeth. So, ta is from danta. This is all beautiful. Panini would have sat for days together to see the place of articulation. And we say that it is very difficult to study, very hard, we don't want.
Yes.
This is what I say. Work has to be respected. We should respect it. That is what is we have to understand. Anyhow, so that is talu and danta. Now, oo, you see, oo, pa, oo, pa, 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 ma. Your lips will be working. That's why they are called oshtau. 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 If oshta is not there, if a person is split lipped, he cannot pronounce pa at all. His pa will be pa pa. Will be pa will not come. That will be the sound. Okay. Anyhow, oshtav. Now, nyamangana namanam nasika. Nga 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 nga. All nasika. You see, you will press your nasika, nasal, and you will pronounce nga nga nga. You see, that is nasika. Now, again, he did not leave. Edaidoho kantatalu odaudoho kandoshtam. You see, A is the protector of A and E. A is the protector of A and E. A plus E is equal to A, correct?
Yeah, yes.
Yeah. So, A pronunciation place is kanta, right? E is talu. That's why A is kantatalu, mathematics. Right? A plus E is equal to A, then the place of articulation of A is kantatalu.
Kantatalu.
Correct? Now you see, O. O is the product of A and U. A is the, U is the product of A and U. A, kanta, U, lips. So, kandoshtau. Kanda and oshta. Correct? Kandoshtam. Now, Y is a beautiful letter. You see, vakarasya dantoshtam. Vakarasya dantosha. See the beauty of that one. Why is the product of actually U plus A? U plus A is equal to Va. Ego energy. U plus A is equal to Va. But U is Oshtam and A is Kanta. Actually, Oshta Kanta we have to say. But why you pronounce? Va. 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 You see? Va.
Va.
So, danta's role is there. First, danta only. Ah, that is why danta and oshta.
Yes.
Because your vamanam, you know, your Ayurvedic people, vamanam word is there. Actually, vamanam means vama shabde.
Vamanam.
Vamanam is only, the root meaning is only shabda, the sound. When you pronounce va, how will you pronounce? Va. When you do the vamana, how the sound will come? Va.
Va.
That is why Vamana has been given the terminology Vamanam. Vama, idi shabdam karodi idi Vamanam actually. When you are pronouncing, when you are vomiting, Vama shabda will come. Wow, will come. That is why that process is called Vamanam. See, the coining of the terminology in Ayurveda, Vama Shabde, Karmani Lutta, Karane Lutta or Karmani Lutta, you will get Vamanam. So this is the way the words are being coined. This is the beauty of Sanskrit that which you have to understand. Anyhow, Dantoshtam, I think you understood, right? And other two sounds are not that much important for us. Jihva Mulia, because Jihva Mulia is very much needed for Vedic pronunciation. Sahasragum, Sahasragum, Gum, Gum, Sahasragum, Hukka, Hukpa, like this pronunciation. Half of the Visarga and Ka and Pa. This pronunciation is more in Vedic chantings. Normal Sanskrit, half Visarga is not there. Hukka, Hukpa, like these words are there. When there only Jihva Mulia and etc. Okay, now you have noticed there are two types of prayatna, Abhyantara and Bahya. There is external as well as internal are there. So accordingly, the sounds are being divided into Sprishta, Isha Sprishta, Vivrida, Samvrida and Ishad Vivrida, like this. That means it is depends upon the mouth. Mouth open, little open, widely open, very widely open, not at all open. That is why when you pronounce a, you should not open your mouth. Actually, that is the pronunciation of English A. English people will not pronounce A. Malayali people, if you ask them to pronounce A, they will say A, they will say. But pure accent A, if anybody pronounce, they will say a book. There is a book, a book, a book. You see, a. A is the similar letter for the A. That is why you should not open the mouth. Okay, anyhow, there is a beautiful phonology for Sanskrit also. Okay, this is what is I want to tell you, because don't think that English has got accent. Sanskrit has got powerful, very strong accent system in it. And it changes the meanings also. Fine, next page. Charuji, entering into the last parts of the Satnya Prayana. This is all Shwasanada Gosha Gosha. Anudit Savarnasya Cha Apratyaha. Now, Pratyaya. Actually, what is Pratyaya? You see, when you split the word Pratyaya, Prati and Aya you can hear. Prati and Aya Pratyaya. Prati and Aya Pratyaya. Prati, E, Aya, A, E plus A gives Ya. Pratyaya. Iko Yanachi. Now, prati is a upasarga, means towards. Aya, in gadav dadu, movement. Towards the movement. The word has to move towards its meaning. Because if there is a word, it should move towards its meaning. Correct? So, pratyaya means that which leads the basic root to its meaning. That is pratyaya. The part that which we add along with the basic root to give its perfect meaning is called pratyaya. That's why the terminology is pratyaya. Okay? You all study Vaidika Subhashita Sahityam in first year?
Yes, sir.
Chikilsita Dharma Shastraha Pade Pade Pratyayam Avahandi. Chikilsita Dharma Shastraha Pate pratyayam avadangi. Pratyayam means result, the fruit.
Pratyaya added to the verb or noun?
It is with the basic root. Pratyaya will be added with the basic root. Suptingandam padam. Subandantingandam cha patasapnyam syat. That is pratyaya. So, that is pratyaya.
Yeah.
I hope you understood now.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now comes your santi. There are two types of santi possible. One is samhita, another is samyoga. See, samhita. Samhita is a coin term. Samhita means varnanam atishayitaha sannitihi. Atishayitaha. If you read atishayitaha, shayanam. What is the meaning of shayanam? Sleeping.
Sleeping.
Yeah. Atishayanam means above sleeping. Sleeping above. One varna sleeps above another varna.
Sleeping, sonam.
Understood? One varna, one alphabet, sleeping over other varna. You see, E and A. I is leaping over E and produces ya. So this is Samhita Sandhi. Got it? A is
okay.
Understood? A
sleeping.
Yeah, E is there above. I is coming. Both of them together joining and making ya.
Yes,
so that types of joining of the words are called Samhita.
Okay.
Yes, anything yes, like that. A yes. plus E gives A. A plus U gives O. You see, this is all Samhita only. Because they are all one word and another word totally joining together and produces another one. That is Samhita. Clear? Next yes, is Samyoga. Samyoga is just joining. Just joining. Varna, say, hello Anantara, Samyoga. K plus Ka, K plus Ka, Ka. Right? Chu plus Ta, Sta. Mu plus A, Ma. This all can be considered as, this all can be considered as Samyoga. Joining, just joining. Nothing happens. Hope you understood. So there are two types of the Varnas can be together. One is in Samhita manner, another one is in Samyoga manner. I hope you understood that also. Right?
Yes,
now,
yes,
what
sir.
Is a word? If anybody asks you, what is a word? Actually, Padartha Vijnana will tell that. Padam. Define Pada. Define Pada. In Padartha Vijnana, ask, you will say that Varna Samuham Padam. Right? You will tell Varna Samuham Padam. That means, if you join so many alphabets, it will give Varna a word. Will it give? Kachatadabha. Is a pada? Kachadadaba. It is not a word. Kachadadaba cannot be a word, right? It cannot be a word.
Yes, sir.
There are varnas. Ka, cha, ta, ta, ba. It is together. Kachadadaba. Yeah, it's not a varna. It is not at all a pada. There should be varnas, many varnas, joining in such a way that it can produce a meaning. So we will say Shaktam Padam.
Yes.
We will say Shaktam Padam. Another definition in Padartha Vijnana, right? Yeah. That which is the ability to produce a meaning is called Shaktam Padam.
Shaktam Padam.
So Varnanam Samuham Shaktam Padam. This much is there for completing the meaning of the word. In Sanskrit grammar, there are something called Suptingandam Padam. Either you have to add Suppa Pratyaya or you have to add Tinga Pratyaya to make a basic root into a word. If you wanted to create a word, either you have to add the Suppa Pratyayas along with the basic root or Tinga Pratyaya.
Tinga Pratyaya.
Yeah. If you add Suppa Pratyaya, what will happen? You will get nouns.
Okay.
If you add Tinga, which what will you get? You will get verbs.
Okay, so
sup is for noun, thing is for verbs. So they are the basic pratyas which use the right meaning to a basic root for getting a word which is either a noun or a verb. So ram is a basic root. Ram. Means to make others happy. Rama means to make others happy. When you are adding Su Pratyaya along with the Rama Dhatu, you will get Ramaha. Rama plus Su is equal to Ramaha. You see, Rama plus Su is equal to Ramaha. Now, Namaha word meaning is very clear. A man who is capable of making others happy.
Happy.
That is what is Rama. We pray Lord Brahma, Rama. Why we respect Lord Rama? Why we have devotion in Rama? Because of his life. He never made himself happy. He made others happy in his life. Okay. That is the message Rama is giving. So, Ramaha, the word is formed from Rama plus Supratyaya. In between, many, 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 many process to make Rama plus Su is equal to Rama. Kartari Shab. There are so many sutras in between worked to make Rama plus Su is equal to Rama. Same Ramadadu with the Tap Pratyaya, Strilinga Pratyaya. You will get Rama. With the same Ramadadu with the Strilinga Pratyaya, you will get Rama. You see, Tap is a Strilinga Pratyaya.
Yes.
When you add a Tap, it became Rama. Rama is a Stri, Ramaha is a Pullinga. Correct? Basic root is same. Who changed the meaning now?
Yes.
The Pratyaya changed the meaning. That's why I told you. Pratyaya is a part that which leads the basic root to a perfect meaning. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So, Suptingandam Padam. By this, we are completing the Sapnya Prakarana. I think you understand Sapnya Prakarana in a nutshell, right?
Yes, sir.
Clear for you? Are you satisfied?
Because yes, sir.
Charu kept some faith in me. I told, okay, I will teach. It should be fulfilled. Otherwise, Charu will be a failure. Charu should not fail. Even I fail. She should not fail because she is the person arranging all these programs. It's not very easy to arrange a program. If somebody is invited, they should give what you expected. So I think Sapnya Prakarana, within the short time, I explained to you. I hope you would have understood it. And you can write anything to Charu. Charu will be passing to me. I will answer afterwards. No problem. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Now we are entering into Achyusanti Prakarana. The very first sutra is Iko Yenachi. You know, actually, the method of learning sloka, first you have to split the sutra. Ikaha, Yanu, Achi, Iti Tripatam Sutram, like this, Sanskrit scholars will study. We don't want that much. We know that Ikaha is there, Yanu is there, Achi is there. There are three verbs. Ikaha is there, Yanu is there, Achi is there. So, Ik, Yanu, Achi. Ik, Yanu, Achi. Ik, immediately we have to remember Maheshwara Sutra. Ayuna Ruluk. Ayuna Ruluk. So, E, I, E, Una. E, U, R, Lir. How many letters? Four letters. In Ik, there are four letters. Right? Yanu. Hayavarat Lana. Yavarala. Four letters. So, E, U, R, R, Yavarala. Now, E, Ya. U, Wa. R, Ra. Lir, La. This is the Sandhi. Along with, if it is added with ach, any vowel. Okay? So, E plus A gives Ya. U plus A gives Va. R plus A gives Ra. Lr plus A gives La. Now, E plus U gives U. E plus U gives U. U plus E gives V. R plus E gives Re. Lr plus E gives Li. So, if you add Ya, when you add E, then E, U, U, R, Ir, like this, it will be keep on changing. That is eco energy. I will show you that how it changes in the another one format I made. In that one, you can see. So that is Yanusanti. The example in your book is Suthi plus Ubhasyaha, Suddhi Ubhasyaha. In Ayurveda, thousands of examples for ego energy you can find out. Yadi plus Abhi, Yadhyabhi. Yadi plus Abhi, Yadhyabhi. Like this, lot of examples you can see in Samhita books. Next, Tasminiti Nurdishte Purvasya. Little more up. Stani Antaradamaha. Actually, these sutras are not that much required for the Ayurvedic students for understanding the Sandhi. Those two sutras are mainly for understanding the sutras. Okay? So, we are not going to learn again the grammar sutras. That's why I think that is not that much important for you. We want Sandhi. Okay? So, next is Anachicha. Anachicha. And Jalam Jas Jashi, all this you say, this all comes, say Jalam Jas Jashi. This all come under inside rules. Small changes will happen. We'll go to the next one. Samyoganda Silobaha. Yeah, enough. Ejo Ayavaya Vaha. Next very important one for you is echo ayavayavaha. Very important sutra. Lot of examples must be there in Ayurvedic textbooks. So echaha is there. Ayavayavaha. Ayavayavaha when you split. Ayi, avu, ayi, avu. Ayi plus avu plus ayi plus avu. That is ayavayava. Ayi plus avu, ayavu. Avu plus ayi, ayavayi. Ayavayi plus avu, ayavayava.
Sir. Sir, please pardon.
Tell. Tell, please.
So it was not audible, please pardon.
It is not audible. Can you hear now?
Yes, sir.
Fine. Okay. Sorry. So echaha kramad ayi avu ayi avu ed a I o au. Ay ayavayavaha ayavayavaha ayi avu ayi avu edesyuhu. A plus a gives ayi. O plus a gives avu. I plus a gives I. Au plus a gives av. Like this santi. This is called echo ayavayavaha. It's a santi called echo. This santi is the dvau plus api. Dvau plus api. Can anybody answer? Sweetie, can you answer? Dvau plus api? Dvavapi.
Dvavapi.
Dvavapi. Okay. So like this, yes. Santis are there in our Ayurvedic textbook. Tau plus abhi, tavapi. Doshau plus api, doshavapi. Okay. Doshau plus api, doshavapi. Doshavapi. If you do not do sandhi, if anybody give you doshavapi, we will be struggling to split it. Doshavapi, how to split? Dosha plus avabi? No, it is no chance. Api, doshau plus api, we have to get. So there are two doshas involved. You see, there are three doshas. In that one, only two doshas involved. That's why doshau, doshau is divajanam, right? Divajanam plus api, doshavapi. So this ideas we will get when you know the santi. Anyhow, H-O-I-Y-A-V-A-H-A is such a santi. Especially aukara, more examples will be there. And the other one, rarely in Ayurveda, it is being noticed. Okay?
Yes.
Here, Hare, Vishnave, Vayagaha, Pavagaha. These all words will not give you much helpful for your Ayurvedic understanding. Ayurvedic understanding, Dvavabhi, Tavabhi, these words are there. Many, many places, doshavapi, dvau doshavapi, there are slokas like this. So there are all places, ayavayavasanti is very important for you, for an Ayurvedic scholar. Next page. Vantoyi, this is an exemption. Vantoyi pratyaye is an exemption for the ayavayavaha. Same only, but this rule is applicable only for and two only, O and AU only. Remaining places it will not come. See the examples of that, Charu, little more up. You can see Ayurvedic example will be there, you see.
Hari plus A, Hari.
No. Next page, Charu. Next page. Charu. Let it move. Here you see. Gavyam. It is an Ayurvedic term, right?
Yes, sir.
What is the meaning of Gavyam? What is the meaning of Gavyam?
Cow.
Not cow.
From cow.
Gaika. Ka has to sell. Gaika. Goho idam Gavyam. This is that of the cow. That is okay. Gavyam. Gaika is very important. Only Gai if you tell, no sense. Gavyam. Mm. So that word you can say. Go plus. Go plus yam, actually. So ya will come. Nyat yes. Is the pratyaya added. So go plus ya. Gavya. Mm-hmm. Okay. This is an exemption for ajo ayavayavaha. Gavyam is formed like that. Navyam will not be there in Ayurveda. Navyam is for the nav plus yam, navyam. That means nauka. That means in the ship.
Yeah, okay,
yeah, sir. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, sir.
Naugaka, naugaka, we can say navyam. Okay, anyhow. So, gavyam is with ejo ayavaya vaha, but an exemption with vando
no,
yam. Yeah, it's a small exception.
Gojo.
Next to Gunasandhi. Gunasandhi, I don't have to teach you. You would have come across with Gunasandhi many times. A plus E gives A, A plus U gives O, A plus R gives Ari, A plus L gives Ali. Yes. But Ali will not be there in our textbook. So R will be there for us, right?
Gunasandhi.
Varsha plus Rudu.
Varsha.
Okay, simple, simple, very simple one. Your Ayurveda only. Tulya plus Rutu. Tulyartu. Tulyartu.
Tulyartu. Tulyartu.
Can you say which sloka it is? Can you say which sloka it is in Attangardaya? First chapter.
Aishkamya.
Where? Context. Sadhya. Sukasadhya. Sukasadhya.
Sir.
Sukasadhya.
Sukasadhya. Tulya dosh. Tulya akrit.
Yeah. Tulya akrit.
Sir, mehe. Tulya dushyata. Oh, wala.
Listen, all of you. Sukasadhya roga. Where it is told sul tulyartu, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that is okay. That sloka, if you remember, you can recall it.
Yes, sir.
Can anybody in this group can recall that sloka? Sukasadhya.
Tvare tulya ritu dushatvam pramehe tulya dushita raktu gunne puranatvam suksadhyashi lakshanam.
Yes, very good.
Puranatvam.
Very good. Anyhow, that is Ritu, that they are all the Gunasandhi is very much used by us. Okay, so Gunasandhi is a very important Santhi in Ayurveda. Next, Charu, up. It's all they know, just I'm just covering it, that's all. Okay, that is all. Ad Gunaha. Move up. No, you're downward, you're moving. Upward, you move. Next pages. Next pages. One more page. Yes. Now, you see. That's all. No, you came 2-3 page down. Just previous page you take, previous page. Enough. That page. Vriddhiradej, Vriddhireji, yeah. That is all. Next page. One page, Charu. Slowly you move. One more page down. 24th page. 24. This is 23. 24. Little more. Yeah. So here if you come, you can see Maha plus Rishi, right? Maha plus Rishi, actually R gives R sound. So we will be confused. So they are added one sutra there. Uryanarabraha is sutra added. And A is added. That's why A plus R gives R you will get. That is why Uryanarabraha. Then you will get Rabraha Sanneva, Krishnardihi, Tavalkaraha, Tulya plus Rudu, Tulyartu, Varsha plus Rudu, Varshartu. Varshartu.
Varsharitu.
Not Varsharudu. Varsharitu.
Varsharitu.
You should not say Varsha Rudu. See, if you say Varsha Rudu, one alphabet is added. Your Anushtup Vritta will go wrong. Varsharthu. Varsharthu.
Varsharthu.
Yeah, that is the pronunciation. Okay? So, otherwise the... Varsha Rudu you should not say. For understanding, Varsha Rudu. But Varsharthu. Varsha plus Rudu. Varsharthu is the pronunciation. Okay. Next page, Charu. Vriddhi Radhi. Yes, this is Vriddhi. Enough. Vriddhi Reji, Vriddhi Radhich. In that one, Vriddhi Reji is the sutra that which gives Vriddhi Sandhi. You know, actually the word itself is showing that Vriddhi. Vriddhi means not a small development, one more step above. That means you see, A plus E plus... A plus A gives I. Right? A plus A gives I.
Yes.
Now, you see, A plus A gives I. When you split A plus A. A plus E is equal to A, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So, A plus A is equal to I. A plus E is equal to A. A plus A is equal to I. Did you notice?
Yes. Yes.
A plus E is equal to A. That is guna.
Guna.
Only one guna. Time. Now, next one is Vriddhi. A plus A gives I.
I.
Yeah. So, that is Vriddhi. That's why Vriddhi. It is called Vriddhi. Vriddhi means multiple change. Vriddhi means multiple change.
Change.
There are three letters in that one. A plus A means A plus E. Right?
A plus A.
Mathematics. A plus A is equal to A plus E. Am I right or wrong?
A plus
A is equal to A plus E, correct?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Why? Because yes, A is equal sir, to A plus A.
Yes.
Clear? That is why it is called Vriddhi Sandhi, because three letters together, it is involved in that Sandhi. Three alphabets.
Yes, sir.
A plus A is equal to I. That is why the terminology is Vriddhi. Why I am telling means, you see, your dosha, Chaya is there, Vriddhi is there. Am I right?
Chaya.
Yes, sir.
Chaya. Yeah. What is the difference between Chaya and Vriddhi? In Chaya condition also, there is increasing.
Sahati Rupa Vriddhi Chaya.
It is not Adhirupa, Sthana Bramsham. It removes from its place. If it is filled in its own place, then it is called the Chaya. If it removes from that, goes away from that, yeah, that is Vriddhi. That's a beauty. That's why I told you here.
Vriddhi.
Yeah. So it leaves its place. It leaves its place. Then Vriddhi. Same way Guna and Vriddhi in grammar. Guna is just two letter addition.
Okay.
Right?
Yes, sir.
Generally, Sandhis are two alphabet addition. But in Vriddhi, three alphabet addition. Clear?
Yes, sir.
That's why I told you similarity. You think in such a scientific way. Then you will get, okay? That is why the terminology is Vriddhi. A plus A gives I. A plus I also, I only. A plus O gives AU. A plus AU also gives AU. I hope you understood that. That is Vriddhi Sandhi. And in all this Sandhi, there are some exemptions. Generally, the exemptions are rarely found in Ayurvedic textbook. But in literature, they are plenty. That is why this sutras, Etyeda Tyutsu, there is a sutra in your Laghu Siddhanta Kaumudi. There are so many examples told in that, under that sutra, which those examples are not there that much, because Eti, Etati, Ud, Dadu, all this Dadu comes, then there will be Vriddhi instead of Guna. See, Charu, little more up. Charu is busy with the phone. Yeah. See, Prashta plus Uhaha. Actually, Prashta plus Uhaha. Prashta ends with A. Uha begins with U. Actually, there should be only Guna. But exemption, it becomes Prashta Uhaha. So, these all are the exemptions found in literature. Sanskrit literature. Rarely in our Ayurvedic textbooks. Okay. So, I don't want to spend much time on that one. We are just moving towards the important Santis, okay? Clear?
Yes.
If you want, I will explain to you. You tell me, if you want to get it, I will explain to you. No problem. if anybody wants. Okay. Next page. Next page. Next main textbook. Ashtanga jump. Okay, now see there are two words they used. How can you differentiate dhadu and prefix? That means upasarga. Upasarga English you can say prefix. Upasarga English you can say prefix. Prefix when you say it is easy for you because you were all studied in English medium. Prefix, fix in front, right? Pre means before.
Yes,
fix means fixing. So prefix. Upasarga. Sanskrit will give upasarga, going behind. That means the word will go first and this will go behind it. That's why upasarga. So upa plus sarga, upasarga. Okay, samibe sarjadi, srijadi idi upasarga. That goes along with, that is upasarga. But in English, prefix. This is the meaning of upasarga. There are 22 upasargas. You know, these upasargas are playing very, very, very vital role in your Ayurvedic terms. Now you see, vikaraha, there is a terminology, vikaraha, right? Vikaraha meaning is, nobody is telling. Ayurveda, please. Vikaraha meaning is?
Hello.
Hello, Pooja, tell. Pooja, you tell. Meaning of vikaraha is?
Rog, disease.
Yes, disease. Why vikara is called disease? If anybody asks you, why that term vikara is used for rog? If anybody asked you, can you explain, Pooja? You know actually why? Vibaritaha karoti iti. Vikaraha. Viparitam karyati or karoti iti vikaraha. Viparita means in a wrong way.
Wrong way.
Anything that which acts in a wrong way. Who is the basic constitution of the body? Doshas. Doshas has to do some action. If it is doing in an opposite way, viparita way, then it can be called as vikaraha. Yes, vivaridam karoti iti vikaraha. Then it is roga. Not at all. Same Pooja, you answer to my next question. Vikaraha is there in padartha vijnana. Mula prakriti avikriti vikadadhyaya sapta. Shodasha vikritayaha. Shodasha vikritayaha. Vikaraha. What is the meaning of the vikriti or vikara there? See, that is why I told you that it is created, that which is created. Visheshena karoti iti, vishesham specific, not from that which is specific, created one. That is why vikaraha terminology, there it is specifically, visheshena karoti, vishesha, here vivarida. In this is vivarida, there it is vishesha. You see, one V changed the complete meaning of the word, right? Am I right?
Yes,
so
sir.
This is the power of upasarga. There are how many upasargas? 22 upasargas.
22 rupasargas.
Prapara, pasamanu, avanisanir, dusadur, viyang, niyati, apiyati, su, ut, abhiprati, pari, upa. Have you noticed the list below that?
Yes,
prapara,
sir.
Noticed?
Yes. Yes,
yeah.
Sir.
There are 22 upasargas. These 22 upasargas play a vital role in changing the meaning of the words in Ayurveda. So you must be familiar with these words. Very much familiar.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay. All these 22 upasargas are very, very important for us. Very important for us. So this is called upasarga as they are fixed previous. Pratyas are fixed afterwards. You see, prefixes are fixed before the word. Pratyas are fixed at the end of the word. So, before, end. This is the difference between pratyaya and upasarga. I hope you are following me. Right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes,
suffixes sir. Are added in the later part of the basic root. Prefixes are added previous to the basic root. Then, you will get prefix and suffix difference. I hope you understood. Then what is dhatu? There are thousands of dhatu. Dhatu means root. Sanskrit dhatu means root. In grammar, dhatu means root. You know, what is the definition of dhatu in Ayurveda? Puja? How many pujas are there? Puja, H-U-I. Puja, H-U-I. Please answer.
Yes.
Now, please answer. What is the meaning of dhatu in Ayurveda? Dharanad dhatu means, listen, if you say dharanad dhatu, then dosha can be a dhatu. Because the dosha also is doing the dharana karma. Am I right?
Poshana.
Somebody told. Poshana. Yes. Yes. Dharana and poshana has been done by dhatu.
Dhatu.
Yeah. Same way, in a word, the basic root will hold and nourish the meaning of the word. That is why the dhatu terminology is used for the basic root. Understood?
Yes, sir.
You see, similarity in grammar and similarity in your Ayurvedic terminology.
Ayurveda.
Yes, yeah. Sir. The basic root supports the word's meaning as a stable one, as well as nourishes the meaning of the word, joining with the prefix and suffixes.
Yes.
Clear? Yes. Same way in your Ayurveda, dhatu holds the body and joining with the mala and the dosha nourishes the body also. Right?
Yes, sir.
So, this is the way dhatu terminology is suitable for grammar as well as Ayurveda. See, this is what is grammar. This is what is word. This is what is terminology. We are learning Sanskrit for terminologies because our subject is written in Sanskrit. So terminology, understanding the terminology is a must for us. Okay. So dhatu.
Yeah.
So here there are thousands of dhatu. They are divided into 10 groups. Dhatu pada they are called. Each group has got some characteristics. So just two examples they told. Bhu adayo dhadavaha. Bhu and va. Bhu is the basic root everywhere you see, because bhumi, bhavati, everything is from bhu dhatu. Bhu sattaya, that which is existing is bhu dhatu. Va gadi gandaneyoho. So like this, there are so many thousands of dhatus are there divided into 10 groups with its particular characteristics. That is why you see, you can see bhu dhatu latlaga bhavati, but kru dhatu latlagar is not karyati. Bhu dhatu latlagar is bhavati, but kru dhatu latlagar is karyoti. Because it is in the different gana, the grammatical rules are different, so it become karyoti. Understood? So,
yes.
According to the gana, the forms will change. If you by heart a word, Rama Shabda, you tell. Then keeping Rama Shabda, if anybody asks you to tell, you tell the form the form of Rama Shabda. So, Rama, Ramau, Ramaha, if you write, it is wrong. Because Rama is Akaranda Strilinga. Rama is Akaranda Pullinga.
Pullinga,
yeah. So, different linga, different gana. So, the same way, the basic roots also are divided into 10 ganas and they have got 10 characteristics. So 10 types of forms will be there for each ganas. Okay. But the same gana, all the dhatus will be almost in the same format. It will not change. But gana to gana, the form will change. Clear?
Yeah. Yes.
So this is called dhatu. I hope you understood now. Clear?
Clear? Yes,
I'm asking you each step clear, because I told you, I am invited for you to make understand the things. You would have taught by great teachers, but still 2 hours, something I should give you. Okay?
Yes.
So my duty has to be clear. That's why I'm asking you. If you say yes, I'm satisfied. If you say no, again, I will explain. That's all. Charyo has to sit for 4 hours. That's all. I don't mind. I don't mind in sitting 4 hours or 5 hours. She has to sit. Next page, Charyoji. Charyoji, next page. Yeah, main text. Here, you see, here also exemptions. Upasargad ruti tato. That sutra is in the previous page. No need of changing. I will tell. Upasargad ruti tato. It is an exemption for gunasandhi. Actually, pra plus richadi, only prachadi has to come because a plus r gives ari. Pra plus richadi, prachadi has to come. But he found prachadi as the form. So it is an exemption for gunasandhi. So he made a rule for it. This is what is Panini's work. You know, I told you, he traveled almost every crook and corner of India. And he collected all the words spoken by the people. And he found the change in them. And he gave a common rule for maximum. And exemptions, different rule he made. Same way, upasargat ruti dhatu. If an upasarga ends with akara, and the next word begins with r sound. So instead of guna, there will be vriddhi, a will come. Instead of a plus r, ar, you will get a plus r is equal to r, you will get. The rule is, the first word should be an upasarga. The upasarga should end with akara. And the second word should begin with r sound. In that case, so pra, para, upa, sama, all this upasarga ends with akara, right? Next. Next word should begin with R. Then there will be, instead of Ari, R will be there. This is the classification he has made, and he put a simple rule for that one. Upasargad Ruti Dhatau. One rule he. So this is an exemption for Gunasandhi. Exemption for Gunasandhi. Okay?
Gunasandhi.
Yeah. But I did not see much word in our Ashtanga Hridaya 15 chapter. Almost all words I have done the Sandhi, but I did not see example for these types of exemptions in Ayurvedic textbooks. Maybe very rarely in Charaka, it may be there in Ashtanga. For 15 chapters, I did not see at all. Okay. Next one is Yengi Pararupam. This is another exemption. Yengi Pararupam. Actually, first word ends with A and second word begins with A. Certainly there should be Ayavayavasandhi. A plus A gives I. But there is an exemption. Pra plus Echate. Vriddhi Sandhi. Pra plus Echate. A plus A gives I. Right? A plus A gives I.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Then pra plus Echate must be Praijade. Praijade. But you see the word? Prejade only. Prejade only. So this is an exemption. This is an exemption for vriddhi sandhi. Exemption for vriddhi sandhi. Instead of vriddhi, guna has come. Instead of vriddhi, guna has come. Okay. Upa plus oshati, uposhati. Actually, upa, a plus o gives au. It should be vriddhi. But here, upa plus oshati, uposhati only. This is also exemption. Yeah. This is also exemption for vriddhi sandhi. So guna exemption, vriddhi exemption. I hope you understood now. Yeah, this all are the exemptions in our Sanskrit grammar. But again, uposhati may be there in our grammar, in our Ashtanga textbook. Uposhanam is oshati. You know that oshati means all oshati, oshati, ushadadu. Ushadadu prayoga is more in Ayurveda also. Aushadam is derived from the root ush dhatu. Okay?
Okay.
Are, yes, you listen, sir. Are you listening me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Aushadam, yes, sir. Oshadhi, yes, sir. All these words are derived from ush dhatu. Ush dhatu has got the meaning ush, ush shabda, ushnam. You know that, ushnam, heat. You know, what is the nature of ushna? Ushna always makes the conversions, right? Yeah. Aushadam is called because it is the byproduct of Oshati, Oshatayaha, Oshati, which gives flower, fruit, and etc. That is why they are called Aushati, Aushati, Oshati. Because Pitta is always causes the conversions. If Pitta is not there, conversion is not there. If heat is not there, conversion is not there. If the tree has to flower, there should be ushna. Without ushna, there is no flower.
Okay.
Understood. That is the role of pitta. Pitta always responsible for conversion. You would have studied in Charaka Samhita, Vibhaga and Samyoga. Do you remember Vibhaga and Samyoga?
Vibhaga and Samyoga, haan, Paradigun mein.
Paradigun mein hai, aur?
Yes, 26th chapter.
Padarth mein bhi hai na?
Padarth mein bhi hai.
Padarth mein bhi hai. Yes. That is the thing. So, first Vibhaga, then only Samyoga, as far as Ayurveda is concerned. First Vibhaga, then only Samyoga. Because Samyoga is a permanent entity, everywhere Samyoga is there. Then it has to be Vibhaga, splitted. Then again, Samyoga. Again Vibhaga, again Samyoga. So Samyoga, Samyoga is a permanent entity, and there Vibhaga happens, then again Samyoga happens. It is called conversion, right? Madhura Rasa, in Vibhaga it will become Madhura Rasa. Amla Rasa in its Vibhaga will become Amla Rasa. But Amla. Levana in its Vibhaga will become Madhura Rasa. Conversion.
Yes, sir.
So, that is called changing. So, there the Pitta will work, Ushna will work. That's why Oshadhi also is created in such a word, derived from the root, basic root, Ushadhatu. Okay, anyhow, this is for your information. And next, two are there. We don't want in Ayurveda at all. Manisha, Shivaya, Om Namaha, this all literature. We don't want it actually. This all we can just remove and we can go to the next. Next page. Yeah. Akasavarne Tirthaha. This Sunday I don't have to teach, I think. Everybody knows. Akasavarne Tirthaha. Akaha Savarne. Akaha means Ak. Ak means which are the alphabets? A, E, U, R, and L, right?
I
how will it come?
Yes.
Ayun Ruluk. Yeah. So, A, E, U, R, and L.
Yes, sir.
So, Savarna means the same Varnas. So, A plus A. U plus U. E plus E. R plus R. Lr plus Lr. Or, A plus A. E plus E. U plus U. Or, R plus R. Or, Lr plus Lr. Comes also Dirgha Sandhi only. Then, A plus A. A plus A. E plus E. U plus U. R plus R. Or, A plus A. First one ends with Dirgha, second one begins with Hraswa. Whatever be the format, if A and A comes, certainly only one long vowel will come, A. You add A plus A also, only one A. Such a Sandhi is called Dirgha Sandhi. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So, this is applicable only for five alphabets that are A, E, U, R and LR. Because they are the basic vowels. See, there are five vowels, basic vowels, A, E, U, R, and L. How many vowels are there in English?
Five.
A, E, I, O, U.
That's all. They say five vowels as A, E, I, O, U. We will say that five vowels as A, E, U, R, L. Remaining all addition. A plus E, A. A plus U, O. A plus A, I. A plus O, O. Noticed?
Yes.
Remaining all are joined letters. Basic vowels are only five in Sanskrit also. See the characteristics. That is why Sanskrit comes under Indo-European language. Sanskrit is a member in Indo-European languages. Okay? This also keep in your mind. Father, Pita. Brother, Brata. You can see sort of similarities you can see. Mother, Mata. These all are Indo-European. Same accent, same type of words will come in that one. That's why I told you, Pitarau, parents.
Pitarau.
Parents, parent. Parent means father and mother. Pitarau. Pitacha, pitacha, pitarau. Pitacha, matacha, pitarau. Here, pitacha, matacha, pitarau. Father and mother, parent. These all characteristics of Sanskrit with the English comparison. Anyhow, you know that same way, Ikara and Ukara, Daityarihi, Srishaha, Vishnudaya, Odrukaraha, all the Lagusandhadi examples, you can take any number of examples from your Ayurvedic textbook. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Next also, very much, Engap Padantadati. It is an exemption for Ayavaya Vasanti. Hare plus Ava. Actually, yes. Hare ends with A. Ava begins with A. So A plus A should be Aya. But Aya will not come. A will remain as such, and the short A will become Avagraha. Understood? Alpe vijeshtide shwasam. Alpe vijeshtide shwasam. Can anybody say? Complete the sloga. Alpe vijeshtide shwasam. Alpe vijeshtide shwasam. Can anybody say? Vriddhi lakshana. Vriddhi, vriddhi. Samdhadu vriddhi. Alpe vijeshtide shwasam. Spiktanodara lampanam. Yeah, correct, correct, correct. Alpevi, alpevi, alpe plus avi, alpevi. See, alpe plus api, alpevi, alpe, and after that, avagraha. That sandhi is a plenty in Ayurveda. Rasvakara will become avagraha, A will remain as such. Come on, next page. Charu. Sarvatra Vibhasha Goho will not be there in our Ayurveda at all. That is purely Vedic because it is purely with Go Shabda. Go Shabda. Gavendraha, Gondraha, Gogram. So all words are purely, purely literature based and Vedic based. Okay? That's all. Anekal Shisavarna says, this all comes under Nicha, Avarnuspadayanasya, Indrecha, Gavendraha. Gavendraha, this all sounds purely for Goshabda. Only for Goshabda. You know, again I'm telling you, why Goshabda, this much sutras you see? Because cow is an integral part of Indian culture. That is why there are lot of words coined with the term Goshabda. So, grammar, Goshabda is given more importance because every places the pronunciation changes according to the local language. So, Panini made for rules for each one. Gavagram is there, Gavagram is there, Gogram is there. Same, Go plus Agram, Gogram. Go plus Agram, Gavagram. Go plus, all splitting is same, but the pronunciations are different. Formations are different because different location in India, different people have pronounced in different way. So at that time he updated it with the grammar. This is the final. Now you don't add more. This is enough for understanding. Otherwise, everybody cannot understand the textbook, right? If everybody started creating their own language, their own grammar, then it will be very difficult for others to understand. So he standardized with whatever be the difference pronunciation at that time. Go agram, go grip. Go plus agram, go grip. That is one. Go plus agram, gavagram. That is with ejo ayavayavaha. Go plus agram, gavagram, avagnuspodayanasya. Three rules he made for single sandhi. Go plus agram. You know, this is for the purpose. The people already used. They started using it in the mantras. And now if he say it is wrong, it is a big sin. So what he has done, he justified it with the rules. Understood. That is what is Panini. The modern students, we such students, when we study, what is the need of three sutras? One rule is more than sufficient, we will think. Because we are kamcho. We don't want to work. But Panini was not like that. Panini was very clear. People started using it. I should not disturb their faith. So he made separate rules for separate single words. Go plus agram, gogram. Go plus agram, gavagram. Go plus agram, gavagram. Go plus agram, gogram, engapadandadadi. Go plus agram, gavagram, ejo ayavayavaha. Go plus agram, gavagram, avangaspodayanasya. Gavagram, avangaspodayanasya. You see, three rules for single sandhi. Again, I'm telling you how much broad the scholars in that time. Okay? Because they don't want to disturb the faith in the society. They don't want to disturb the language that which is used in the society. So they coined separate rules for each pronunciation. So I think you understood it. Next one is Nipata. Nipatas also are very, very important in Sanskrit. You see, tu you would have used. In many slogas, you can see tu shabda.
Yes.
Many places, tu sloga. Tu, what is the meaning I will give for tu? Actually, there is no meaning for tu. Is there any meaning for tu? I will ask the coordinator. Charuji, Is there meaning for tu?
Tu, that is used in spoken Sanskrit, not.
Yeah, but it is not spoken. There is scientific meaning for that one. There is rules for that one. It is called avadharane. If you are objecting something that which is told before, or if you are going to take some difference from the whatever it is told previously, or if you wanted to in specify some points in that, in such places, tu must be used. This much rule is there for one nipata. Nipata means single word, which does not have any meaning, but it gives a larger sense in the context. Some people will say that tu is used to fill the number of words in the meter. It is not like that. It is really for giving a perfect meaning to the context. Are you getting my point? So yes. They are called nipada. They are called nipada. The terminology he gave is nipata, is the terminology he has given. There are such so many terminology. These examples, if you see, you will laugh. E Indra, U Umesha is the examples in Laghu Siddhanta Kaumudi. While learning this, you will feel that what is the need of creating all this U Umesha, E Indra? Whether he is having some hiccup problem or any other problem, why he is speaking like this, we'll think. But it is not like that. Oh Ganesh, when did you come? We will say, na? Yes. Oh Ganesh, when did you come? Why you used Oh Ganesh?
Oh Umesh.
Umesh, you leave. Oh Ganesh, why did you come today? Ganesh. What is the meaning of Oh there? Sweetie, can you say what is the meaning of Oh Ganesh, why did you come today?
Exclamatory sign.
It can be an exclamatory. It can be a question tag. There is a question sensing from inside. Right? There is an exclamatory. What a wonderful thing it is. Yes. Exclamatory. Oh, why did you come today?
Yes.
Oh, there is a question in oh itself. Right?
It's for Sambodhan.
Yeah. So, it's not Sambodhan. It is not at all Sambodhan. How it is Sambodhan? Hi, Ganesh. When did you come? Okay. You say it is Sambodhan. Oh, Ganesh. If you say it is not Sambodhan. It is increasing the meaning of the context, right? Because the question, next time I'm going to ask you some question.
Okay,
because I have some doubts in my mind. I want to clear it. For that, the sound has come first. Because I did not expect that you come here. So I did not expect that feeling is there in that O.
Yes.
Clear? So yes. This is the way the Nipadas changes the meaning in the slokas as well as in the prose used in Ayurveda. So they are called Nipada. He gave the terminology Nipada. There are three terminology, Nipada as well as Abhyaya. Another terminology they give is Abhyaya. There are so many Abhyayas in Sanskrit. Yatra, Tatra, Kutra, Tadu, Yadu. Like there's so many Abhyayas you can see. Uchaihi, Bhakyaha. Like there's so many are there. So many Abhyayas are there. Abhyayas can change the meanings. All Upasargas also are called Abhyaya. Abhyaya means it will not change. It is standardized form, but it does not have a perfect meaning of its own. But add the meaning to the context. So they are called Abhyaya. Very important thing that which one should know when they are learning Ayurvedic textbooks. It is called Nipada or Abhyaya or Upasarga. Clear? I hope you understood.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. See, there is a sound.
Yes.
Oshnam. You would have heard Oshnam. It is there in Ayurveda. Oshnam. You know what is the meaning of Oshnam? Ishad Ushnam is Oshnam. It is there in your Laghu Siddhanta Kaumudi. It is Ayurvedic terminology. Ishad Ushnam, Oshnam. Actually, Na Ushnam, Oshnam. Actually, Na Ushnam, Oshnam. Na Ushnam means not heat. But but here the meaning
not
is
hot, but
yeah, Oshna means
little
negligible. The heat is
negligible.
There, but it is negligible.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. So that negligible sense you will get from the word A plus Ushnam, Oshna. Na plus Ushnam. Na plus Ushnam, Oshnam, there is no heat. A plus Ushnam, Oshnam, it is. I hope you understood.
Yes,
Ishat, negligible. This is the power of Nipada. Oshnam is a terminology is formed with the support of a Nipada, with Ushna, to create Oshnam. Then the meaning is negligible heat.
Yes.
I hope you are following me, because this is all very important, very minute, but when you go to the research level understanding or PG level understanding, these all are very, very important for you. UG level, it may not be that much. In clinical level, very, very important, all these types of words. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Aho, it is not there in Ayurveda. Come on, next page. It will not come. Actually, say Vishnu iti Vishna iti. In many places you can see. One example I will tell you. Brahme Muhurta Utteshte. Brahmo Brahme Muhurta Utteshte. Muhurta Utteshte is the word you are learning, right? Dinacharya, I hope so. First sloka, first sutra. Brahme Muhurta Utteshte. Right? Rakshartam Ayushah. That's loka. That's sutra. Muhurta Uttishte. Actually, when you split it, you will get Muhurte Uttishte. Brahme Muhurte Uttishte. Saptami Vibhakti. Muhurte Saptami Vibhakti. So that A is removed and Muhurta Uttishte is the word. It is with the sutra Lopaha Shakalyasya. Then you will get Muhurta Uttishted. You see, Vishnu Yidi, Vishna Yidi, Vishna Vidi, three forms for single word like that. I am giving that example. Muhurta Uttishted, Muhurta Uttishted, Muhurta Uttishted, like this, different types of words will be there. So, Muhurta Uttishted comes that Egara is undergone deletion. But when you understand, you should understand it as Muhurte, Tayeva Dosha, Tayeva Dosha. When you split it, Te eva doshaha. Ta eva doshaha. When you split it, te eva doshaha. This is also Ayurvedic Ashtangardaya line. Ta eva dosha sama vivrudhyai. Like this one sloka is there. So there also, te eva. This is also very important santi. Ekara will be deleted over there with the sutra. Two sutras, Hoyavaha as well as Lopaha Shakalyasya to give Muhurta Uttishte. But you should take Muhurta Shabda in Saptami Vibhakti, Muhurte Uttishte. Okay, so that is also very next, not required at all. Maya Unyo, Ova, all these things are not at all required for Ayurveda. It is for drama. Rityakaha. These words you can see. Sometimes Brahma Rishihi would have been given. You should understand it as Brahma plus Rishihi, Brahma Rishihi. Yeah, that sound you should understand as Brahma. Brahma is the sound which Anda Shabda, sweetie. Brahma is the sound which Anda Shabda. Which Anda. Which Anda means, just like Akaranda Pulinga, like that. Brahma.
Shabda is, Oshto.
Brahma. Which Anda Shabda. Nakaranda Shabda.
Nakaranda.
Brahman Shabda. Sleshman, Sleshma is the Nakaranda Shabda. Sleshma, Sleshmano, Sleshmanaha, Sleshmanam, Sleshmano, Sleshmanaha, Sleshmana, Sleshmabhyam, Sleshmabhihi, Sleshmane, Sleshmabhyam, Sleshmabhyaha, Sleshmanaha, Sleshmabhyam, Sleshmabhyaha, Sleshmanaha, Sleshmanoho, Sleshmanam, Sleshmani, Sleshmanoho, Sleshmasu. Like that, Brahma Shabda also.
Okay.
Nakaranda Shabda. So, if you do not know the Sandhi, Brahma, then you cannot understand it as Nakaranda Shabda. In such places, Rityakaha Sutra is very much useful for us, because after Akaranta, if R comes, sometimes it can become Hraswa instead of Guna. Exemption for Guna. Brahma plus Rishihi, Brahma Rishihi, you can say that answer also is there. But sometimes there may be Brahma Rishihi also. Clear?
Yes.
So by this, I think all the sutras in Achchasandhi Prakarana is over. Over and you can you put the first sloka of the Ashtangardaya?
Yes,
Ashtangardaya first sloka. Ragadirogan. Just for Samhita Padanam, just I will start because already whatever be the time she told that is going to be finished. Achchasandhi has taken 2 hours class. Okay. I think you understood from my class. फर्स्ट श्लोक क्या कह रहे हो? रागादिरोगान्वलनम्। प्रसृतान् अशेषान् औत्सुक्यमोहारतितान् जघान यो पूर्ववैद्याय नमोऽस्तु तस्मै। वन्स् अगेन् ऐ विल् रीड्। रागादिरोगान् सततानुषक्तान् सततानुषक्तान् अशेषगाय प्रसृतान् अशेषान् औत्सुक्यमोहारतितान् जघान यो पूर्ववैद्याय नमोऽस्तु तस्मै। See, ragadi, ragadi rogan, ragadi rogan. You are getting raga and adi shabda. Raga plus adi, ragadi, savarna dirgha sandhi. Aga savarne dirgha. But ragadi is a samasa. Ragaha, adau, yesham, te, ragadayaha. Ragaha, adau, yesham, te, ragadayaha. That means the list can you hear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so raga adi ragaha adau yeshante ragadayah. So you should know the list. Raga, dvesha, lobha, moha, mata, matsarya. There are six. This six is there in our culture. So raga, dvesha, lobha, moha, mata, matsarya adayah. You should know this from your culture. It is not there in our Ayurvedic textbook because it is there in Dharma Shastra. Okay, now raga adi rogan, they themselves are rogan. See, raga adi themselves are rogas because you know that dharana vega, right? Which are the dharana vega?
Yes.
These are the six dharana vega: raga, dvesha, lobha, moha, mada, malsarya, krodha, dukkha, shoka, etc. etc. are dharana vegas, right? Manovikara, they are all mental diseases.
Mind disease.
Raga adi rogan. See, to understand that, you see, ragaha adihi eyate ragadeha in the Sanskrit vyakhyana. You should know Sarvanga Sundara vyakhyana. Just first line you see, ragaha adi yeshamte ragadeha. Unless and until you see, there he has given, dvesha lobha adihi griha agraniyaha. You should take that, dvesha lobha moha mada malsari has to be taken. This is the way we have to learn the Samhita. Understood? If you read an English textbook, you will not get it. If you do not study properly the things, you will not understand. Ragadi Rogan. Now you see, Satatanushaktan. You see my pronunciation? Satatanushaktan. So Satata and Anushaktan. Satatanushaktan. Upper Udata. Satata Anushaktan. Satatam is an avyaya, always. Anushaktan. Anu is a prefix. Sakta is the word. Anu plus Sakta, Anushakta. Anu means behind. Sakta means attached. So, going behind. Anushaktan. Satatanushaktan. So, going behind always. Which are the diseases going behind with us always? raga, dvesha, lobha, moha, madha, malsari, etc. In this 2-hour listening class also, our mind will be thinking thousands of things. Because somebody is angry, somebody is cohabitation, somebody's problem, thousands of things will be going on, right? That's why it is called satata anushatthan. Yes, please. Somebody ask something.
Sir, which sandhi is in
satata anushatthan? You tell satata
anushatthan.
Yeah, very clear. A plus I is equal to A. Savarna Dirgha Sandhi. Correct only. Very good. Anushaktan plus Asheshakaya Prasadhan Asheshan Nasheshan Nasheshan Nasheshan. See, Nasheshan Nasheshan. Nakara I pronounced as Nasheshan plus A. Na. So I will get Kaya Prasadhani. Asheshan, I will get. Same way you say, Ragadi Rogan, Satatanushatan, Ashesha, Asheshakaya, Asheshakaya. So, Asheshakaya. Otherwise, we will read it as Nasheshakaya, second line. Right? Actually, first line, Anushatan, Asheshakaya Prasudan. Asheshakaya Prasudan. You see, Asheshakaya Prasrudan. So Anushaktan plus Ashesha. Anushaktan Ashesha. Samyoga. Nu plus A. Na. That is Samyoga. Now Asheshakaya Prasrudan Asheshan. Asheshakaya Prasrudan. Ashesham. See, this is all telling. Ashesham. What is the meaning of Shesha? Remaining.
Balance. Remaining.
Remaining or balance. What is the meaning of Ashesha then? Not remaining. What not is remaining. Dharma? Virtue. What is Adharma? Not virtue. So what is the meaning of Ashesha? Not remaining. Not remaining means what? Complete, right? So instead of telling Sarva, the author used the word Ashesha. You see, why Vagbada would have been used that one? If you say Sarva, there is a possibility of exemption. But if you use Ashesha, there is no possibility of exemption at all. So it assures. That is the characteristic of Sanskrit language. If you say Sarva, Prayaha is understood. Majority is like that. But there may be some confusion, some exemption. But if you use Ashesha, no possibility of exemption at all. So Ashesha Kaya Prasada means spread that certainly in all bodies. That is confirmed. That is why he used the term Ashesha instead of Sarva to show the meaning complete. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Once again, the characteristics of the language. This all you must know while learning it. Ashesha Kaya Prasradan. You see, Pra Uvasarga Sridadu. Sridadu, Ayurveda people know, right? Saradi, Saradi Gachadi, that which flows, that which flows. Sri Sarane, right? Sri Sarane. So, Pra Ubasarga is added. You know, Pra Ubasarga? Prakarshena. Prakarshena means in the very high sense. That is Prakarshena. So, Prakarshena Saranam means it is spreaded, it is flowing just like anything. We'll say not just like anything. Prasaram. Such a powerful flow. That is Prasrutan. That's why that Prav Vasarga is. It is not spreaded simply. It is spreaded in an extraordinary way, in a high way. That is why Prav Vasarga is added. Prasrutan. Again, you see, Asheshan. Instead of Sarvan, Asheshan. Again, Nasheshan. That means nobody is left out. So why two times Ashesha? One is Ashesha Kaya, every body. In body, everywhere. Another one is Asheshan, completely. Not remaining. The disease is not remaining even a little. 100% Raga in 100% body. Could you understand? 100% Raga in 100% body. So it is the 100% body. Not only human body. Animal body also. Bird body also. In everywhere, this raga is there. That is why two times Ashesha. The roga completely, the whole body. Such a way, two times Ashesha Shabda is used by him. This is not my explanation. It's not beautifully explained by Sarvanga Sundara in his textbook. Yagarana down, Yakhyana. Time is not there. Okay, next one. Outsukya moha aratidan. You see reading? Outsukya moha aratidan. Outsukya moha aratidan. Outsukya moha aratidan. Outsukya moha aratidan jagana. I'm not adding a completely, but I is there in the accent. Outsukya moha aratidan jagana. Right? So the letter is not increased, but I is understood by Udata. Outsukya moha aratidan jagana. So, Outsukya, Moha and Aradi are the three main diseases caused by Raga, Dvesha, Moha, Moda, Matsarya, etc. Outsukya, Outsukya. Again, Outsukya. Utsukatayaha bhavam. Utsukata means excitement. It has a character, that is Outsukya. So, excitement has a character in us. Whatever it may be, Outsukya. So, that is called, you will translate it as anxiety. In English,
anxiety.
Na? Correct now? Outsukyam, anxiety. Now, moham. What is the meaning of moham? See, Malayali people, you ask moham, they will say that.
Delusion.
Delusion. Muh mohane. That is, muh means left. Who is not working there now? In delusion, who is not, which faculty is not working? Whoever may be told delusion meaning, which faculty of the knowledge is not working there now? Can anybody say? One of the faculty for attaining the knowledge is not working in the deluded condition. Which is that faculty?
Dhi.
Buddhi. Ah, dhi. Correct. Dhi. Dhi is not working. That condition is called moha. So deluded condition. Who is deluded actually? The buddhi is deluded. Deluded. It's not acting properly. English meaning. English also prefix is the de. Deluded. So that is moha. Ratitan. Arati. What is the meaning of arati? Rati. Narati arati. Narati arati. Rati is the wife of Kamadeva. Where there is desire, there will be rati. Where there is desire, there will be rati. Desire is there, attachment will be there. Attachment only causes the desire, or desire causes attachment. Whether the husband is responsible or wife is responsible, we don't know. Where there is desire, there will be attachment. Where there is kamadeva, there will be attachment. Where there is attachment, there will be kama, desire. Okay? So rati means attachment. So arati means detachment. Detachment. But detachment cannot give. D is actually not complete negative. D cannot be complete negative. Okay, in English, D cannot be complete negative, partial negative. But arati means complete negative. It is nanya talpurusha. Narati arati. Okay, again, I am telling you how the words cannot give the complete sense. Okay, next one. Next one is aratitan jaghana. Jaghana. Jakana is a little lakar. Again, I could not teach you lakara. There are so many lakaras. In that one, lit means present perfect tense. Present perfect tense. You see, he did the work. See the meaning of that one. He had done the work. Or he has done the work. He has done the work and he did the work. Is there any difference between these two meanings, Charu? Charuji? He did the work. He has done the work.
Uraka has done.
So he did the work. He completed the work. And he has done. Just now only he did the work.
Yeah. He just now only means it shows. The little agar always shows the present. Even in the present, the influence is there. Do you understand?
Has done.
Could you understand? The other one is past. So the Abhurva Vaidya is not the past Vaidya. Even now he is there. Got it? Are you following me? Perfect meaning you have given. Present
yes.
Perfect is even just now, even in the present, the validity is there. Charu missed the line. Jakhana. Yo Purva Vaidyaya Namostu Tasmai. Yopurva Vidyaya. So Yopurva. See how I'm pronouncing? Yopurva. 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 I did not read. Yopurva. Yopurva. Ah. Yopurva. Yaha plus apurva. Yopurva. Yaha means he who. Yachabdam pullingam. Pradhamadvapti ekavajanam. Yaha yau ye yam yau yan. Yena yabhyam. Yehi yasme yabhyam yebhyah. Yasmada yabhyam yebhyah. Yase yoho yesham. Yasmin yeyoho yeshu. Yachabdam. You would have studied in first year. Yaha, he who. Apurva vidyaya. Yo purva vidyaya. Apurva vidyaya. Apurva, apurva. Apurva vidyaya. Again. Na, purva, apurva. Vidyaya, chaturthi vibhakti. Vidyaya. Ramaya, Krishnaya, Balaya, Vidyaha, Shabda. Apurva vidyaya. Namostu. Again, Visarga Sandhi. Namaha plus Astu, Namostu. Namaha plus Astu, Namostu. Visarga Sandhi comes. If Visarga comes between two short vowel Akara, Visarga will become O and the second short vowel will become Avagraha. That is the rule. Okay? Visarga in between two short vowel Akara, Visarga will become Okara and the second short vowel will become Avagraha. Namaha plus Astu, Namostu. Visarga become O and Astu A become Avagraha. That is Namostu. Namaha salutation. Astu is Namostu. Tasmai. Saha taute tam tautan. Tena dabhyantaihi. Tasmai tabhyantaihi. Tasmai tachabda sadarthi vibhaktiyavayana. For him. Again. You know, there is a grammatical rule. When you are using Namashabda, you must use to whom you are saluting. It should be chaturthi vibhakti. Once again, characteristics of Sanskrit. You should never say that salutation to Lord Shiva, you should not say. You should say only salutation for. What is the difference between to and for prepositions in English? Can anybody say to and for? To is always objective importance. Sorry, to is always subjective importance. To is always subjective importance because the importance will be given for the subject. But when you use for, it will be given importance for the action. I did for him. I have done for him. I did it to him. You see, you are taking the authority of I did it to him. So I did it to him. To him, I did. The two is always gives more importance to I. But I did for him. I did not do it for me. I did it for him. That's the difference between two and four. So that is why Sanskrit grammar has given a strong rule. If you are giving something to somebody, if you are using da dhatu, you should use chaturthi vibhakti to whom you are giving it. And when you are saluting a person, certainly you should use chaturthi vibhakti. When you are using the word swaha, you should use the chaturthi vibhakti word. Agneye swaha, shivaya swaha, brahmane swaha, all chaturthi vibhakti you have to use. You should not use other one because it is for them. It is not for me. If you are giving something to somebody, it is for them. It is not to, it is not to me. That sense will give with the preposition chaturthi vibhakti. That is why it is called Tasmai Namaha. This is the way. I did not read. Again, I am telling you, if you read the Sarvanga Sundari Vyakhyana, you will get the body and mind relation. Why here Ragadi Rogan is explained. Why he did not use Jwaradi Rogan. Ragadi Rogan is mind. I am going to study a science for the body. Why the scholar is used Ragadi Rogan? Because it is very clear that the body and mind are in Adhara Adheya Banta. The body and mind are in Adhara Adheya Banta. Because mind is the Adheya and the body is Adhara. If the body is not there, the mind cannot exist. So, yeah. Adhara is the body, Adheya is the mind. If body is not there, mind is not there. Okay, yes. So that is why he used the Ragadi Roga. So he gives an example. You are having a vessel and you are having so many iron balls. And if you keep the iron balls in the vessel and if you heat the vessel, certainly the iron balls also will get heat. Suppose you heated the iron balls and kept it in the vessel also will get heated because both of them can transform. That means body diseases can cause the mental diseases can cause the body diseases. That is Athara Atheya Vanda. So Ragadi Rogan is the beginning of diseases because when you are getting this Ragadi Roga, you will change your Sadvrta. It leads to physical disorders. That is why Ragadi Roga is given important in this sloka. Arunadatta will explain this in a beautiful manner. And next he will tell another, so many are there. If you go, there are Adhara Adeya Vanta. Next one is another, so many are there. Three relationships are being explained in this sloka. Vyakhyana. Okay, so Vyakhyana has to be read for understanding a sloka. So I taught you Achanti, Charu, I cannot do any sloka explanation. I cannot. So time is already 12:30, you see, 12:30 is the time. I hope all the participants got something what we planned. Please answer, all of you. To Charu, organizer. Chaudhary Madam, Yukita Chaudhary Madam.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, how do you feel? It's okay, class?
Yes, sir, very good class.
Thank you very much, Madam. Charu, you have to say, she organized the class. She has to get the credit. Okay.
Excuse me, sir. So there is a confusion.
Tell me, please.
In Purvup Sandhi and in Visarg Sandhi.
I'll tell you one example, okay? Purva Ruva Sandhi and this Visarga Sandhi, one example I'll tell you. Now, Ramaha plus Abhi, Ramopi. I'm going to tell the steps of how Ramaha plus Abhi reached into Ramopi. Then you will understand what is the difference between this and that, okay? Ramaha plus Abhi is understood as Ramasu plus api, because su prateya, that visarga will remove and will put su sound in Ramaha. Okay, Rama plus su Ramaha, am I right? Yes. So I took Rama plus su and that sa will be changed into ru by the sutra sa sajusho ruhu. So Rama su api now changed into Rama ru api. Okay. Next step, that ru will be changed into u, that is atoror apludad aplute. Atoror apludad aplute. That means if there is a repa, rekara, after a small laku akara and followed by another laku akara, then that ru can become ukara. Okay. That means if there is a ru is coming after a apluda akara. Apluda akara means laku akara, hraswa akara. And after that also, if there is a laku akara, then the ru can be changed into ukara. Now, Rama u api. Rama u api. Rama su api. Rama ri api, Rama u api. Now you see, Rama plus u, a plus u, ad guna, idi gunena, Ramo. Clear? Ramo plus api. Now your sutra works. Engappadandadati idi sutrena. Then Ramo, that o will remain as such. And api a will become avagraha. So in Ramaha plus abhi Ramobi, which sutra acted?
Hello.
Shivanya is the person asked me the doubt. In Ramaha plus abhi Ramobi, which sutra acted in one stage? Engappadan dadadi worked, you know? Hello.
Not audible.
Shivanya. Charu, can you hear me? Charu, can you hear me? Shivanya is telling she cannot hear. I think her sound
is. Shivanya, you are audible.
And there is whizzing sound.
Now it's okay? Now it's okay? Okay, no chance. So, in Ramaha plus Abhi Ramovi, Engappadanda Dadi will work in one stage. That is the difference between Visarga Sandhi and Purvarupa Sandhi. So, Purvarupa Sandhi is included in the Visarga Sandhi. So, what is the knowledge you are getting? In one Sandhi, other Sandhi can influence.
Okay.
Hello. One more example I'll tell you. Ramaha plus cha, Ramascha. Ramaha plus cha, Ramascha. You see, yes, Ramaha will become Ramas when you take s. Ramas plus cha, Stohoschunaschuhu, Halsandhi. Then it will become Ramascha. So, Visarga Sandhi generally is a combination of Swarasandhi as well as consonant, Halsandhi along with that one, Vyanjana Sandhi with that. Visarga Sandhi cannot exist itself. Yes. It always gets the support from both the Santis previously taught. Right? Clear, Shivanya?
Hello.
Shivanya, did you get?
Sir, could we change Vishnu out in Visarga Sandhi?
Visarga Sandhi is a Santi. There, either Swarasandhi will be there in one stage or Vyanjana Sandhi will be acting over there because Visarga is replaced always by S sound. So there is a possibility of influence of the Swarasandhi and Vyanjana Sandhi in Visarga Sandhi. Clear? That is why Ramaha plus Abhi Ramovi, in that place, Engappadanda Adhidi is the last sutra works after Gunasandhi to get the word Ramovi with Avagraha. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay.
Sometimes there are similar examples, so we get confused about
it. Don't get confused. From the Adhigarana, you have to understand. Because you see, Ramopi is Ramaha plus Api. If it is Engappadanda Adhi, it will not be Visarga. It will be Sambodhana Pradama.
Yes, sir.
Okay? You will not get Ramopi in Engappadanda Adhi at all. But Ramaha plus Api, Ramopi, Engappadanda Adhi will work. Directly Engappadanda Adhi cannot be in Ramovi. It is there in Ukaranda Shabda as well as Akaranda Strilinga Shabda. Which are two sounds? Ika, Ukaranda, Guru, Hey Guru, Hey Guru. There Okara will come directly. No other forms are having Okara. So Engappadanda Adhi is purely meant for Akaranda Strilinga Shabda or Akaranda Saptami. Akaranda Saptami A will come. Rame plus Abhi, Rame Bhi. Engappadanda directly you will get. But it cannot be Ramo Bhi. It can be only Rame Bhi. Okay? Clear?
Yes,
so, Engappadanda Adhi generally will come for Sambodhana Pradama of Akaranda Strilinga Shabda or Ukaranda Pullinga Shabda or Akaranda Saptami Ekavajana. Clear?
Yes, sir. Yes.
But Ramaha plus Abhi, Ramobi can never be directly an example for Engappadanda Adhi. But Engappadanda Adhi will work over there at the end after Gunasanti. Clear?
Yes. Yes, sir.
That is that. So, Charuji.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
So thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you so much, sir.
हमें usually संस्कृत को
देखते
हैं घोष जैसी फील आती है जब हम फर्स्ट ईयर में होते हैं सेकंड ईयर में होते हैं फिर वो टच ही खत्म हो जाता है बट वो सर आपने लर्निंग प्रोसेस इतना इजी और इतना इंटरेस्टिंग बना दिया कि हम लोग को दोबारा से अब इतना पढ़ने में मजा आ रहा था सबको थैंक यू सो मच
Yes, I think all of you have benefited by the class. And again, I'm telling you, if you have any doubts, please send to the channel and the Charu will send to me. I will certainly reply all your doubts clearly. Okay? Yes. I'm sure.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.